What's up, everybody? It's me, Psycho Blue, conduct the high train, Mr. Hype Gems, hashtag Crosswires, and once more, hashtag Street Fighter Cross Tekken. And boy, oh boy, guys, I got a lot of important updates for today's stream. This is going to be my third attempt of getting these Discord matches showed to you guys. I know there's a lot of technical difficulties last week, and when I actually streamed what I had, it was... I didn't have everything I needed, but I'm going to do it again because I'm rejuvenated because I have a lot of great news to share with you guys. Make sure everything is nice and neat. My mic is on, which is fantastic. Look at this. It's good. Let's jump into this. Let me see if I can get the chat to pop out so I can hear you guys talk if you guys are visiting. All right, where is pop-out chat? Task review, chat settings... How do I get to pop up? They changed the settings again. Pause chat. Slow mode. Nah, don't report me. How do I get this chat to pop out? Let's see here. I guess we'll worry about it later. Let me see if I can get everything stretched out and where I can easily have the chat next to me while we get started. Did they remove pop-out chat? That stinks. Deleted messages, pause chat, local icons, tasks, review recent raids... Oh, there we go. They made it so there's different settings if you're a mod or not. Let's begin. I'm all buzzed up now. A lot of great stuff going on. Turn the sound back on while we're at it. Sound is not on. Good thing we're checking all this beforehand, right? I know exactly what needs to be done now. There we go, that's the pepper. That's perfect. All right, let's begin. Just a bit. There we go. So before we get into the nitty-gritty of this, guys, I actually have some really good news. So... There we go. So, before we jump into this, I want you guys to know that I am going to be working directly with Capcom at the Capcom Cup Finals to get you guys every single match of Street Fighter V Arcade Edition that's not paid on one of the main streams. It all started when I asked Gutex about me taking the LGPs I have that I've been recording cross Tekken for you guys in the past 5 or 6 years with, and using those to help out and record everything that we can possibly get. That's not in the mainstream. Maybe I'll help a player out if I have one of his big moments on the recording, so maybe can use that as leverage for his pitch to get sponsored one day, if it'd be helpful. And a month later, last Tuesday, I got a message from one of the people at Cross Counter TV and attached me to a Capcom email chain. They want me to record everything, and they told me equipment's covered. I'm going to be technical lead for Cross Counter, and they trust me enough where I'm actually going to be making a highlight video of everything in the Last Chance qualifier on Friday to present to Capcom to use as stream filler on Saturday during the final bracket of death. And this is a pretty big deal for Street Fighter Cross Tekken, because now I have a way to directly speak to whoever would be in charge of putting Cross Tekken on the Capcom Pro Tour, which means maybe they'll finally port it to modern consoles, or they'll port it to Steamworks, and they'll finally fix the netcode that's keeping having full spectator mode lobbies on PC, which would be fantastic. So this is as far as I've ever gotten to this close to whoever make that decision. Talking to Ono is one thing, but he's a busy man, and he doesn't have time for everything because he's got all these other things to maintain. But a direct conversation with the people in charge of the esports wing, that's pretty major, guys. And thank you guys for helping me make this channel what it is, for keeping this going as long as we have. The fact that we even have Discord tournaments in 2019, almost 7 years, 7 years later, not almost, actually it's 7 years later. It's going to be 8 years in a couple months. The fact that we've kept on this long, I appreciate all you guys for providing this channel support that you guys have had. And I'll make sure I won't let you guys down when I'm in LA in December. Without further ado, let us begin. So, we have most everything other than Jables matches. But to be fair, he's pretty laggy with me, but that's okay. We have most every set in this tournament that was played at this point, other than Jables one within my match. So let's get started with the one that I omitted last time, which would be Phantom Striker versus Broly. Man, look at this. Look at these two names, the Dragon Ball tags. Pretty crazy, right? DBZ number one fan, that's Phantom, versus Broly. You've seen Phantom on my channel before. I had a long set with him at EVO 2018. He's gotten pretty good. He played Law and Lay back then, but he's really gravitated towards Hugo since that time. I'm really glad. This Hugo's pretty scary. Like, Law's always scary, but there's only one way to play Law, which is the right way, and doing all this stuff, because he does so many things well that if you can optimize him, you might as well play him that one way. So it's pretty easy to tell who's a good one, who's not. But with his Hugo, that's a different story. You don't see too many Hugos these days. One, because the game's not as big as it once was. And two, Hugo was kind of rare care to begin with once he got nerfed in 2013. He still hurts like heck, though, so he's not a free ride. Meanwhile, Broly is playing King. Whoa, I like that. So he used the double knee lifts to create like a anti-rollaway situation and pressure the Hugo and wake up, which is actually pretty smart. Look at that. That's also very clever. So because the Jaguar Step counts as an airborne situation, it's immune to the SPD. So Broly is already showing some pretty nasty stuff with King. That being said, I've faced a few Kings in my lifetime. Obviously, there's Esta. There's VR, who's been playing a lot more lately. It is Prime. VR is probably the best King I ever faced. Like, playing his King in 2017 made me less afraid of playing Esta's King a few months later at that EVO where I won. So Either way, I do respect King a lot more thanks to both those players, and it is cool to see what Broly's working on right now. That being said, seems like Phantom is fully in control of the situation at hand. He has... never mind. Here comes King. So King has to finish this. Law has no health, and he's going to be out for a while until he can recover all that red health he has. All right, keep blocking. Good. Good. Excellent blocking from Striker. That's actually pretty scary, to be honest. Those elbows? Not just the high Logan, but the fact that he's pretty gosh darn safe, he just does two of them. He doesn't even need to stagger them. So he has a high low game, or go out low, or go for the overhead. Or he could just throw you one or the other. Typically, I try saving meter when I face King, so I don't have to worry about that, and just alpha counter through the elbows. Luckily for Striker, he kept his cool and did block that mix-up as well as he did. That could have been disastrous, but he kept his cool. And right now it is tied at one round apiece. Excellent. Great corner carry from Phantom. But he loses the corner. He's jumping out. I wonder if Broly could have recovered fast enough to flip kick him. He's going to kind of a late jump out. Missed it. That could have finished it, but that definitely does. EXSPD, invincible on startup, and indestructible as an ending attack. Just crushed Broly's Law. And Striker takes the first game. Shoutouts to Sully Vaughn in the chat. Hope you're doing well, and thank you for the support you have given me by showing up here. I might not look at sometimes, but I'm grateful for everything that you guys have done for me by stopping by, and whether it be to promote me or criticize me, I am driven by it all the same. I don't think I would be the guy I am today, for better or worse, if I didn't have that chip on my shoulder. So thank you guys for pushing me as hard as you have.
I'm ready. Fight!
From DC to LA, guys. XWIRES is rolling high, and hopefully XWTekken will finally have the rejuvenation we've been looking for. It's been a long road. I started doing the whole XWTekken commentary running stuff in 2013, so it's going to be a 6-year journey coming hopefully to a successful end. If not, we just enter year 7 with a new focus and new ideas on how to make things bigger for the game and its community, being I will have a direct conversation with the people in charge of the East Wing at Capcom to know what it would take to even make that happen. Obviously, Namco had to be involved, but in the same... I love that Oki, by the way. That is so nasty. That is so nasty. I'm so glad I uploaded this. I'm really glad that we got this set. We didn't have this set last week, so I'm glad Broly's showing us what he's got with this King. I'd be pretty intimidated if that was what I was facing before. I had to face Esta's 2013 team, because he played Warong King in 2014. They should make it for Xbox One. They should just port it to all consoles, Sullivan, for real. And I was telling some of, like, a streamlined Gems, where it's just defaults only and things like that, and improve the netcode even further. You don't have to worry about League of Legends. This will be the ultimate weapon against the League of Legends fighting game menace entering 2020 or 2021, whenever that game comes out. So either way, in December we'll at least know what needs to be done, if it's not in the pipeline already. Because I have heard some mumblings since Combo Breaker that what we've been doing, especially after we got all those views at Combo Breaker, is getting noticed. Whether it be for the upcoming anniversary for Street Fighter, or even just a sign that maybe Tenkaichi Super is on the way and they'll bring this game back as a filler the same way they brought back Ultimate 3. In between that and Infinite. Hopefully it turns out better than that, anyway. I love Infinite, but it really sucks how that game got done. What was that? What was that setup? Was that a late kick? Or was that just a landing overhead hop into the SPD? That was such a nasty setup. And Striker takes it with a frightening way to set up that SPD. It's like Zangief's knee in Street Fighter V. Just do it. And as soon as you do it, you already know someone's getting thrown the moment that knee hits the ground. Exactly. Either way, we will know for sure when I talk to them in December in between me splicing footage for Arcade Edition. By the way, I like that game a lot. I've been playing it a lot more. So I'm not one of those guys who is just going to say, well, now I can dump Street Fighter V because Cross Tekken is back. No, I like 5 a lot. It's not Cross Tekken. It's not 4, but I think it has a lot of great stuff on its own merit. I generally have a lot of fun playing, even though I'm not particularly good at it these days. So the fact that it pushed me to get better, like, I had a pretty nasty loss to someone who's fairly new to our scene, but he's definitely putting a lot of work, so I felt bad all the same that I had slacked off and fallen behind the way I had. The fact that it's pushing me to learn more about that game shows that the game's worth playing. I wouldn't play if I didn't feel it was worth getting better at. Anyway. Nice block of the... Oh, nice. They're just a swing with those Fury Rush, but I did like how Numba blocked that overhead. Oh, nice. He had delayed a bit and caught Broly sleeping. Sadly, Huey didn't get all of the... that time he got hit with the overhead. But... Nice. Juggle. I didn't know that worked. It's pretty cool. Oh, those Oki setups with the knee! Hey, Jaylytical, how you doing? Welcome to the show, my friend. Ah, good. No, no, not so good. I was about to say it's a good call-out of the jump-in, but sadly, nobody was home. Huey's in big trouble right now.
Open your soul to the battle!
Good stuff, nice. Oh no, that could have been a juggle if you kept it going. Excellent use of the reversal though. Good stuff, Striker. Striker has a 2-0 lead. This whole tournament is played 3 out of 5 because it's an online tournament. I still prefer 2 out of 3 online or not, but it's not my ruling, it's Salt's ruling. So good on him. Misses the flare chop. As a reminder, that has to be up close for it to be cancelable, so even if it did hit, it wouldn't have done anything. King, intimidating law right now. Oh, nice! Stuffed the armor with the multi-hitting properties of the Shaolin kicks. Alright, Hugh's gotta finish it now. Striker has a 2-0 lead. He needs to hang on. Good blocking. Good blocking. This is gonna hurt. This is it. Striker is one round away from taking this set in a 3-0 silencing. You can't lose here. Nice. Man, that target combo reaches so far. I hate that target combo. Like, Law has so many things that make him as good as he is, but that target combo, I don't know, it just irks me. It's like all that in a target combo. It's bad enough that jumping is banned. It's bad enough he has a high-low game. It's bad enough he's safe with everything, but he has that target combo on top of it that just lunges at people. Huge hitbox, small hurtbox. So much priority for no discernible reason other than the fact that you just want to do it. Oh, whoa, the call-out. Jaguar stepping through the lariat. That's just mean, Broly. That's mean. There we go. Wake up, SPD. He gets out, but not quick enough. This is probably a deadlock. Oh, no. Maybe not. No, that's for sure dead. Is Broly playing with his food? Does he feel like he's made that download? Let's find out. Because Striker is still up 2-1. Yeah, I hate that target combo. Sorry, Jaylytical. Sorry, Law players, but Jaylytical is right.
It is very good. The Junkyard combo in this game is one of those equalizer things Law has. Because a lot of those safe strings I talk about, those hard-to-punish boosts, Law can just do that willy-nilly and not have to worry about anything, because it reaches far enough and comes out fast enough where he can punish Bison for that. If not for that move, I probably would have won things a lot sooner than I did, because Law was sick of the person who can't kick me out. Right now it's Rufus, because I don't like the dive kick stuff in any game it's in. But before then it was Law and the Tarkin. So I had to learn how to fight Law very carefully. And it took me like 4 years to finally figure out this is how you face Law. So Esta picked Law and me that one Evo. That's when I was getting serious. I knew that he had finally dropped the Ryu's top tier charade, because picking Law Elena on me. And thankfully the training I did was enough. Thank you, Kev Smith, for making that happen. Nice clap. Oh no! Backdash. I think Phantom's trying to figure out what's the rhythm here. I don't want to do anything. It's not safe. I can't confirm it. Whoa! Staggered the jump in and did it. Oh no. Maybe you should have done the full combo. Might have actually hurt him more than that. Bop, bop. Good absorption, but I feel like Striker might benefit from just letting that lariat rip like that. There you go. He was backdashing too much. He was taking a little bit too much red health and not realizing that there aren't many situations where you have to worry about the armor getting blown up that way. Obviously, there's Shaolin kicks, but typically, while that Tarkov is very good, he can easily identify when he's going to try the next hit or not. And even if he did, it would have come out fast enough to beat that lariat. Because the speed of that Tark combo depends on if it was on hit or on whiff. Same deal with Heihachi's Tark combo. The forward 1-2, that depends on if it actually hit him or not. On whiff, it comes out much faster. So it throws a lot of people off. Same deal with Law's Tark combo. Tap, tap, tap. Oh! That's not the worst idea, using the blocked Fury Rush for a frame advantage to attack cancel. Ah, misses the link. It's gonna suck. Ooh, goes for the Oki and gets a Shining Wizard for his troubles. Broly is playing very fancy right now. Very fancy.
Open your soul to the battle.
Broly seems like one of those guys who will drop things on purpose just to mess with your head and say, I meant to do that. That's what I'm getting with the way he's playing right now. He'd rather force Oki than go for maximum damage just because he feels confident he can blow the other guy up by dropping that on him so many times. It's not the worst idea, to be honest. Because Street Fighter V's all about that. A lot of those cross-under anti-airs and things like that. Where you purposely set someone up with, like, a faulty juggler or whatever, or a faulty anti-air, just so you can Oki them when they land and make them guess, are you going to get thrown or are you going to get hit with a crush counter or something like that? Or a meaty setup. Either way, I'm still going to be at advantage. So I feel like Broly's trying to do that with Law and King with the way he sets up his Oki. It's not the worst idea, I'm not going to lie. Both Law and King have the toolkits to blow someone up that way. There's a lot of things you need to respect from both those characters, both in frame advantage and in priority. Oh, nice. Only went for one poke of the Tar combo and just jumped away, expecting some kind of whiff. Oh, stop with the low attack. Broly looking to come back from a 2-0 deficit and take this set 3-2. Keep it simple, not bad. Oh, whoa, wake up. Raw flip kick. And Striker correctly anticipates. Oh, come on, you could have finished it there! You got too fancy! No, he might have hesitated a bit, didn't expect it to hit all the way. I hope it doesn't cost him. I think actually cost him. This is gonna suck. Bop, bop, bop. I love that juggle though. I gotta save it for later. Big raw launch. Yeah, Jay, I think either Striker's flush or didn't expect to connect the way it did. I think got flushed because he actually confirmed something. Broly's in big trouble though. So, never mind. Broly takes this set and turns about Striker's luck to move forward 3-2. That's a pretty hype set though. I'm glad I recorded it. Thanks, Striker, for sharing this with me last night. How do you like the jersey, guys? Provide an assist for the community. One more assist. Steve Nash. Okay. That being said, let's get to, my sets. What is this? Oh, that's not mine. Where is mine? Must be in the battle log. Alright, first up, let's start off with my set with, I believe, Jables. Man, this was a set. This was a set, guys. The lag monster just suddenly grew like a Power Rangers monster and stomped on my connection. Now, I bought a power line adapter specifically so I didn't have people like Tampa Bison put me on blast for being a Wi-Fi warrior. I bought specifically so it never happened. And it made little. Like, the lag in this set, you would have to see it to believe it. So, yeah. I'm going to put it up here just for posterity's sake, but I could not see anything in this. Nothing. And yeah, Steve Nash is still underappreciated even today. I don't think people appreciate just what he did with that team and how much better he made all of his teammates. And if he wanted to, he'd put up James Harden numbers. I mean, you've seen the numbers when he has like the green light to score, he'd drop like 50 or stuff like that on a whim. Because he was a lights out shooter, he can break the best really easily. Instead, he knew his role, which was to set up shots as well. Yeah, as you can see, the lag's really bad right now. So I'm just talking about basketball for a bit. I'm really hyped about this year for the Suns. I think they're going to be, like, exponentially better than they were the past 5 years, just because they have an actual point guard who has that mentality of just distributing and setting up shots rather than try and be a one-man stat sheet, like many other point guards these days. Yeah, this lag was atrocious, Saul. This is the one that I was ranting about in the moderator's chat. I cannot see anything right now. There would be like a lag cycle where every second there'd be a full 1 second pause. So I have to hope that I catch him on something he shouldn't be doing. Right now it's not really to my avail. Think that he's not very good either. Yeah, this is very bad right now. Horrible lag plus PSP input lag. The input, it's only 2 frames, Salt. The input lag is nothing to me these days. The issue was the lag cycle of like 1 second would pass where there's movement, and then another second would pass where there was nothing. It's like Dio Stan was drunk. Like this actually, so right now I am watching this match through my OBS, and there's like a solid half second lag in between the button you press and what I see on the screen. I think if I just played it through OBS and the connection was fine, it'd actually be preferable what I actually had to deal with during this set. I gotta be honest with you.
Nothing but garbage.
Blue team wins.
But yeah, I like where the Suns are. I think Rubio's going to be a fantastic fit. Finally, Booker and Aiden have someone who can actually pass the ball and have it wind up in the popcorn stands. Plus, I like Sarek decently enough, too. He seems pretty cool. I liked him when I saw him in Philly. And obviously, Kelly Oubre has done a lot to revive the culture in a positive way. So they have identity other than just hopeless losers. Always a start. Next slide. I need to be affiliated with Twitch. I really should. I've been told that. So now that I'm streaming on a minimum weekly basis, that might be the next thing I start doing. Apply for it and make it happen. Because I'm pretty sure I have enough subscribers to do so. But thank you, Salt. I appreciate it. Yeah, I can't confirm off anything right now. I appreciate Salt, thank you. I appreciate that, Jay, thank you. Because most people don't feel that way, but I'm pretty sure they're at least good enough to at least get the A seed. Because people are great on Kerr because they've been such a dumpster fire the past, 6 or 7 years, but all those people who caused that fire are all gone now. So you gotta treat them like they're a new franchise in a way, with more developed players. I treat them like the Las Vegas Knights in hockey. On paper, they're new, but in practice, they're all a bunch of really experienced players getting together and make things happen. So, that the past 7 years, sure, but this is like a complete new look, and more importantly, a new staff. That's the issue. All the troublemakers in the front office are gone now. And so far, I haven't seen that redneck owner of theirs show his face throughout the entire offseason, even though people are talking trash about him. A year ago, he'd be popping off on Twitter or CBS Sports or whatever, trying to show off how out of date he is. But so far, he is kept out of everything, which I need more of. As long as I don't see his face at all this offseason or this season, I'm confident they'll stick through. I don't think you were talking about Saul, just the fact you're saying that. You're just trying to make me riled up. Anyway, let me finish off Jables so I can have a less laggy environment. It's not the Bledsoe days. Thank good it's not the Bledsoe days. I knew it, Salt. See? That's how I knew. Yeah, I like the coach a lot. The fact that he opened the way he did, and the fact that other people wanted that coach, but he chose Phoenix rather than just us having to take like someone nobody wanted, but we had to fill in the spot, that's promising. Because I actually like that Igor dude. It's just, we clearly drafted the wrong guy if we were to run with him. Because when I saw we got him, I was like, okay, we're going to get Luka, and then we'll probably get Capella in free agency. No, we got Ayton, and then we gave him no guards, even though his system that he's won medals and stuff in all need distributors. You can tell it was doomed to fail the moment you saw no point guards start a season. Anyway, let me deal with Jables and this Geef Hugo team. No, so Jables played Akuma, Chun-Li the first two games, and now he's playing Geef Hugo. Now you miss. Oh, nice! That's actually pretty smart! I'm not gonna lie, I was using it to blow up his SBD attempt, because Heihachi's hurt box retracts in a way where it can sometimes blow up SBD attempts that way from that range. But using bear grab against it is actually pretty smart. Yeah, I'm not going for juggles. Juggles are not viable right now. Ugh. See what I mean? Juggles are not viable. I gotta go for hard links, that's about it. No, he played Chun-Li the first two games. Nothing but garbage. What will happen next? There we go, build some meter. I'll probably miss the anti-air. I do want to do... Yeah, you see, I was trying to do the anti-air cross start. Because the lag's so bad, that's what happened instead. I wanted to anti-air cross start him because I was building, so I had three bars. Yeah, we're not even going to be fancy now. No fanciness whatsoever. There we go. Finish the job, maybe? Yeah, clearly. Clearly I wanted a raw tag in his face. It actually happened in a different set. And Salt R knows the one. And it cost me an entire game. But you'll see that when it happens. I'll do a striker sit last. Let's go to Broly's. So Broly, he's playing Huarong Bob. Did you guys know that before Bob was a thing, Huarong's nickname on the Tekken forums was Bob? There's two origin stories I've heard about that. When I first joined Tekken Zaibatsu in like 2005. The first origin was that stood for boy on bike. The second origin is because Huarong was too hard to say, because there was like three pronunciations for it, Huarong, Huarang, and they just called him Bob to avoid confusion for the name. Yeah, I'm serious. You wouldn't know that. This is like old man tech right here. And then they actually made a character named Bob, and at that point, everyone decided to call him what he actually is, which is Huarong. And people mispronounce his name even today. Some say Huarong, some say Huarang. I say Huarong, because how wrong is funnier to say than how rang. How rang is that, dude? Thankfully, before, nice, I missed the tag timing again. I made too much of a call-out, guys. Thankfully, my anti-airs are pretty on point. Yeah, just poke at him, set it up. There we go, I knew something was coming. I've been Electron Godfist too many times by specialists to keep falling for that, for guys on Invisible Reversal. So I just stood pat, know he's gonna do something, and I went for it. You don't scare me, Broly. Ah, there we go. He missed the link, but that's actually a pretty scary setup. I just buffered DP, hoping and praying he was going to drop it. And because his DP is only minus 4 on block, I was going to hope he didn't have the timing to punish it properly if I landed and didn't hit it. Thankfully, didn't have to worry about it. I figured it was a risk worth taking. So I faced Duck the week before to help get ready for this tournament. So I could be ready in case I did to face a Huarong or a Raven. I don't know what to make of Broly's Huarong right now, to be honest. I feel like, and this is what I said when I played him, I feel like Broly tries too hard to be fancy when he doesn't have to. Check out the perfect fighter. He assumes a lot of people are just going to flinch at whatever crazy setup he's going to have in mind. But for me, the worst that happens is I get thrown. Or hit with an overhead, you know? I've gotten better at blocking the overheads. There we go. I just went for a simple link that time. Didn't want to get too fancy or drop anything. It is tournament after all. There we go. Nice, good block. So I need to count how many times I try to go for empty lows. Because I have gotten raw launched or DP'd when I go for them too much. In fact, I almost dropped six against S at Evo for doing that too much. So let's... What I do when I play now is I think about weird setups I hit people with, and then I, what I call, mark it off my list, knowing that I have went to the well for too many times, it's time to retire it, I must use a new bag of tricks to surprise the next time I have the situation. So far, he's playing really well, though. Yeah, this time I just waited my turn, tested with a 3-frame normal, and went forward. Nice. Probably could have anti-air. It was kind of tight. I got the air-to-air, though. One mix-up? What did he wake up with? What did he wake up with? Ah, that's not the best idea, but okay. You notice I love that setup. I love using the light medium and then spacing them just right to put the stomp on them if I have to. It puts me just out of range of most of their Poke normals. It's a character-specific thing, but I find it's really nice against Bob in particular because of the size of his hurtbox and the range of his normals that would reach that far. He could just raw launch me if I do too many times, though, so I gotta be careful how many times I do that. If you're watching this and I do it on you, expect a stomp and be ready to raw launch me the next week. He switched to Ogre. I don't agree with this. I think Bob was doing more work for him than Huarong was. I think Bob Ogre could have been a real problem for me. Or if he just kept with the Huarong, Bob would have been nice. Maybe because he figured about the stomp, he thought Bob was the problem. Did I break his spirit, I wonder? Nice. Okay. So, thankfully I used the right medium. I missed the Thunder God Fist. Keep blocking. That could have been disastrous! Alright, he's opening up really bad right now. Doing the fancy stuff now. Thankfully I have a DP. Alright, so I'm taking a breath, and never mind, I just wasted it. Okay. He did mix me pretty well there, I'm not gonna lie. I was expecting an overhead or two, but it's one round. Let's take a breath. He's probably adapted. He has had 5 rounds to do it. Gotta keep an eye. I missed it again. I'm gonna drop this game. I'm gonna drop this game for being an idiot. I had this in the bag. There we go. Okay, he got a little too fancy there. He was doing what he did with King a little bit earlier, trying to think I was gonna flinch on one of those weird mix-ups. Get out of there. Ah, a little too soon. Bop, 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 bop. Come on. Ah, he got me that time. Dot, 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 dot. Come on, man. I got Mirror. You know what I'm about to do. All right. I am on set point now. I've gotten away a little bit too much these past 2 rounds. It's time to clean things up. And be aware of what he's about to do. Ah, nice! Pick! Alright. Ah, I missed it. Oh, got him that time, never mind. Nice little pick-me-up. Bop, bop, fancy stuff. Here we go. Which way? Oh, the back. Sorry, buddy. Bop, dot, 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 dot. Wake up. Ah, not the right one. Oh, that works too, though. Bop, bop, bop. Bop, bop, bop. Bop, bop, bop. Alright, what are you gonna wake up with? Nah, you missed. Dot, dot, dot. Alright. Move forward 3-0. Pat in the back. Okay, next up, and this should be for the tournament, Striker versus Psycho Blue.
I'm
ready. Fight!
So, when this tournament started, Broly was one I was most worried about, just because I didn't know much about Broly. It's been a long time since I played him. Thankfully, my concerns were somewhat unfounded. He's good, but just playing solid and patient was enough to get the job done. Striker, though, you don't know what you'll get. He adapts pretty gosh darn quick and always bring a different approach every single round he plays. I'm letting him around for a bit for now, just so I get out of my system. Using a round or so to kind of fill someone out, even if you lose, is not the worst idea. Even if you get mollywopped, you'll at least have an idea of what not to do next time. That's the way I look at it for this game. The game's long enough where you have enough time to figure that out. Some games like some Marvel games or anime games, where if you get hit once, you're dead and you never learn anything. That's one thing. But this game, you have all the time to kind of set up shop, feel someone out, develop a strategy. Ah, he got a little bit too fancy. Went for the overhead into launcher. Keep it going, keep it going. Da, 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 da. I like this a lot. Watch what he does. That's smart. That's actually really smart. So, what that means is now I am banned from just doing that at will. Salt lambasted me a while ago for doing that way too much, but I don't have to. But I actually use that to see how the opponents are going to respond. So if the clock is ticking down, how much time can I kill depending on how they react to it and how much they respect it or not? Obviously, you can't dive at Law because he has the flip kick. But it's unlikely he will chase you down in time to full-on punish if you just float away from him. Yeah, he's in the way. Very smart. I didn't get there fast enough. Bop, 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 ba-da. Ooh, nice. Dot, 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 dot. Cross up? Nah, he blocked it. That's intimidating. He's gonna do this a lot, by the way. I'm actually really scared when he does that. When he, like, hops towards me and nothing's going on, I'm actually pretty intimidated by that. Because Hugo's a very intimidating character. Yeah, he has a lot of problems, but when we get started, he is pretty nasty. Because that could happen. Look how quickly this went south for me. Look how quickly this went south for me. Yeah, I just went my fastest punish there. I knew the DP was fast enough to punish it. I said, I'm not going to risk any buttons that should be mashing. I'm just going to go for it. DP, let's do it. And thankfully, did the job. You know what would be hype though? When I go to Capcom Cup and I do all this stuff for Cross Counter and Capcom, if they offer me a spot, like some sort of position, I don't know if that's possible. Because, like, after all, I just kind of volunteered to do this. I didn't expect you to kind of spin off the way it did. But they respect my hustle this much, I gotta consider it's a good resume builder. And the BCBA field has moved along in a way where I could do both. So. Either way, for now, my focus is helping out, making sure a lot of players have nice little resume builders with the footage I'm going to upload of them beating all these top dudes. And hopefully, when I talk to Ian, he's the guy in charge of esports at Capcom. It's not that Kotaku nut, by the way. That guy's weird. This is a different Ian. This is someone that no one in the FGC knows. Like, all the esports wing in Capcom are guys that no one really knows. I guess they got tired of all the buddy systems and things like that affecting their bottom line. If nobody knows who they are, maybe they'll be less inclined to have the expectation of these players that used to do other stuff. Not the worst idea, having an objective approach. When I talk to Ian about Cross Tekken, whether it be, yeah, we'll make it happen, or we have to do this first, at least I'll have an answer of what we'll have to do moving forward to bring this game back in the forefront. And create the opportunity for all these devoted Cross Tekken players that I'm playing and still play to this day. Or even those who play a lot back in the day and want to get back into it, like Brent or Chris T. Brent has earned my respect. I mean, I gotta say, at first I thought it was gonna be another guy just kind of like whittling by because if I was working out for him, but he stuck around a long time. He's still around. And I respect him for that. I didn't I guess I took him too lightly at first, and I got kind of mad, but he's pretty cool. He's earned my trust. And a lot of people feel like I'm not worthy enough to even have the kind of opinion about people, but hey, I've been in this game a long time, you know? And I always, like, respect people if they are that serious about it. So props to Brent and props to everyone who stuck around for this long. In the meantime, let me see if I can stick it to... Oh, that was nice. Pat myself on the back right there. Okay, so... The past few months, I've been telling myself I need to stop being so intimidated by Law. Because Law typically plays one way. It's a very strong, dominant, annoying way, but it's still one way. There are definitely tools I could use to at least catch him whiffing and use more of those good old-fashioned footsies and not worry about the priority problems that I've been having against him. Rather than him stuffing me, I will stuff him and using that standing medium punch is the way to do it. There we go. I'm getting a lot better about this. Just, identify those gaps and strike. Ah, I missed the full... There we go. Anti-air Psycho Crusher. Shouts to CBS2.
Nothing but garbage.
You can't back down now!
I gotta say, I actually do like how Striker plays, though. I'm not just saying because I'm winning. I'm saying because Striker... The potential is there for him to be really, really scary. I gotta be honest. Like, now that he's playing Hugo instead of Lei, I think it's working a lot better in terms of, like, how he likes to play and what he relies on Law doing and what he relies on Anchor to doing. I feel Hugo's better for him than Lei is. Lei is someone who is, like, all high-low games, but in general, I'm pretty intimidated by throw mix-ups, more so just high-low mix-ups. Because you can still block 50-50s. You can't block an SPD. And against Hugo, as you can tell, jumping over him is not the worst idea. It's not the best idea either. You could jump over him because he has a high hitbox and stuff, but he could just shoot you out of the air at the Brat Breaker. Man, look at this. He's putting the pressure on me right now. There we go, chip out. Doesn't work Street Fighter V, but it still works here. This is delicious! Bison's game is too much. Okay, for the marbles! To save my tournament aspirations, and to once again get that nice little neon green title in the Discord. Well, neon yellow, more like it. So I can finish the job. I'm up 2-0.
I'm ready. Fight!
I'll fight you, little one.
Let the madness begin! Fight!
Yeah, I'm poking with that standing medium punch. Ah, medium scissors! Not the worst idea. Dot, 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 dot. Da, da, da. There we go. I missed it. I buffed a little bit too quickly. Da, da, da. As a reminder, that little ambiguous setup I did against Broly's Quarong, not gonna work on Maul, he'll just flip kick out of it. The light flip retracts his hurtbox in a way where he'll just hit it cross up or not. Not gonna risk it. Alright, yeah. Watch this. When he dashed up to me, alright, yeah, he's really bopping right now. This is bad. This is bad. This is bad. I just died in a horrible manner. Hugo just destroyed me. Yeesh.
You can beat me. Look at my
Did you
mother.
See that though? The way he was sticking, but not just to bait my DP? That was nasty. I'm actually kind of offended, Striker. You'd think that little of me. And the fact that you'd be right. That puts self-loathing on my list of things to be mad about. He caught me with the standing leg kick this time. God, that move sucks too. It reaches so far! You don't expect a light kick to reach that gosh darn far, but it does! And it's like... Bison's standing medium kick type far. It's ridiculous. I missed the full combo. I just got a little confirmed there. I guess I didn't expect a hit. I just went, all right, let me save before I drop something. I use those life punches just to kind of test to see if I actually hit them or not. I caught him not all the way, though. It was all the way up in both hits. Thankfully, he did not anti-air me for that. I'm lucky. I thought I was going to throw out like a Fist Fury Rush, something like that. Ooh, he could have low-profiled me there. It'd have been disastrous. He could have punched me there. Wow, he's starting to blow me up a bit. I'm like so flustered by that first round, I can't get anything done. All right, keep it simple for now. There we go. One round away!
Tremble before me. You can't lose here. Fight!
Ah, there we go. Walk up and three frame him.
Pretty weak.
Ah, caught him again. He did. Oh, there we go. He got me that time. Think I had defense gems on. EX through it. Get me out of there. Got him. Oh, never mind. There goes all my health. All right. What I want here. So I was kind of doing this. I got that. Dot, dot, dot. Oh, no, I missed it. Self-loathing, full effect. And you know what's sad? If I had just done a regular juggle, I would have probably had enough to just tag Heihachi back in. I wouldn't have had to try a faulty relaunch combo. I could just tag back in. I just realized that. I didn't think I'd have enough meter to build for it. So I did that instead. I just threw the whole game away. Man, he's intimidating me. No, that was my fault. That wasn't lag. That was me think I had enough airspace to hit the relaunch and I didn't. Oh my goodness. Okay. Let's try this again. Okay, I'm still up 2-1. Let's try it again. This time, we are not going to be intimidated. We're not going to give the game away by doing that or by walking into SPDs or whiffing DPs. Well, I don't have to because I'm not even in SPD range. There's no need for me to be that risky or that much of a call-out, dude. We're just going to keep it simple. All right, here we go. Let's see if we can adjust ourselves. I admit, I was pretty rattled after that last game. I was like, oh my god, what have I done? I had it. He's about to destroy me. I'm being intimidated by Hugo. Oh, there we go. Here we go. I'm about to get warriored here. Striker might be West Coast. Look at my Cavaliers all the same. Bop, 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 bop. What a disastrous opening. I didn't respect him at all there. And I'd spent all the other rounds being so careful what to do, what not to do. Got him. Okay, that time I got him. I spaced it just right. Heihachi's staying in. No matter what, Heihachi has to stay in. I have all these attack gems. Bro, he just dashed up and SPD'd me. That sucks. Oh, no. And he's... All right, he's hopping at me. I'm like, okay, I got out of here. He's going to hop SPD me all the way through. Now, keep in mind, I can't see what happens. He's looking for it now. He is making these crazy comebacks. Now, I need to be very careful. I was, like, freaking out here. I was like, what am I going to do? There we go. Just walk forward and hope he's doing something that doesn't have a high recovery. We're about even now. I gotta open them up carefully. Like that. I could have done a combo there. I expect to actually cross them up with that. Whoa, he's tapping me. Get away from me. Get away from me, you big buffoon. Whoa, I tried to be a little bit too fancy with that anti-air target combo. Nobody home. Oh god, he's tapping me. This stinks. Got him. Got him with the crouching medium kick of all things. I don't use Heihachi's regular normals that much, but I'm so glad I used that one. I was running out of options. I was like, oh god, he's going to just reverse 3-0 me. Okay. We're still in this, guys. We can do this. One round away, and I have taken this little round robin. I got him. Tapped him just enough for him to flinch. Got him again. This time with standing light punch. Yeah, standing light punch, not medium punch. Nah, got me with EX flip. Bop, bop. Keep blocking. Keep blocking. He's gonna dash up and try to SPD me. He has no mirror to like reversal though. Keep doing it. Keep doing it. Got it. Okay. Caught him there. Nothing fancy. Just do that. Get some frame advantage. Come on, come at me. I know you want to. I know you want to. Come on. Come on. There you go. No claps here. This is a no applause zone. Hold your applause. Get out of there. Tap him again with three frame, and this might do the trick. Dot, dot, dot. Jesus. Look how much. Look how little damage that did. I hit him like three times, and he had no health all those times. The third hit finally did the trick. And once more, the first time in like what has to be like a year, I am now King of the Hill in the CrossSecond Discord, which means that we'll be going to PC the next time, and I'll have to face Brent again. Hopefully I won't get reverse 3-0'd like last time. That would stink, because that definitely put me on blast the rest of the tournament. I did get past Lenneth and Max, but it would have been nice if I didn't have to worry about having to go through losers. So I was out of steam by that point. Pat on the back. Let's see here. The thing is about everything. What's this? Oh, liquid. All right. I'm gonna show this one liquid match and then we'll get going, because I always like seeing what liquid does. And come on, it's a Dalsim match. I gotta show at least one Dalsim. I haven't shown a Dalsim forever in this game. It's been a long time since I showed a Dalsim. His Dalsim's actually pretty cool, I'm not gonna lie. So let's do this, then I'll wrap things up. This will be a bonus match, guys. Me versus liquid. That one morning, I woke up like 5 a.m. to get ready for the autism walk, and he was there waiting for, because he works like really weird hours, so he's up like really late night, and he goes to bed when everyone else is waking up. Keep in mind, this is 5 a.m. I actually not going to be what it should be, because I'm like a zombie. I just felt like playing something until I got salty, and I said it's too early for this crap, and I walked off. So let's make this happen. Yeah, that's Street Fighter V, though. It's been a while since you've seen one in Cross Tekken, though. There were some good ones, though. Tokido played Dalsim, and he was really good at it. Arturo played Dalsim, and he won Civil War 2013. I know Salt's not intimidated by Arturo. I think Salt, like, bopped Arturo, he told me. We talked about how good Dalsim is, like, years ago. He said, well, I just crushed his Dalsim. I found what was wrong with him. He's nothing compared to Lars. And having played Arturo Dalsim since then, I can kind of see where Salt might have been unimpressed. Anyway, let's see what Liquid's got. Ibuki is not as scary as she was when I was facing Homeless. Now I realize it's more the fact that I was just concerned about Rufus and Ibuki vortexing me more so than Ibuki herself. She's intimidating, but there are methods around her. You just gotta be ready to, hold if need be. I didn't do it there. Ibuki is not the second best Street Fighter character. So Brent says Ibuki is the second best Street Fighter character in this game, and I am calling complete shenanigans on that. She's not the worst, but she is not close to the best. Just because I lose against Ibuki doesn't mean she's the best. Okay. So, it's been so long since I have faced a Dalsim, period. So I do appreciate this. Get out of there. Yeah, because she has that back medium punch, I can't really stomp her or do anything like that. Just a matter of me just kind of playing carefully and not doing that. I was hoping I had her doing a crouching medium punch, like whatever that long one is that has a good deal of recovery, but she was not. Again, it is 5 a.m. I don't know why I did that, but okay. Nice. I tried hitting him with the light God Fist. Looking pretty hopeless. I tried dumping in. He didn't really chase me there. He definitely can, though. Yeah, I'm just kind of going in. Oh, he threw me away. Come on. Maybe he has no health, so if I do hit him, I can probably turn this around. Ah, nice. Good block. There we go. I just used the Psycho Crush to get in when I had to. And I missed what I was going to do. And, whoa, he caught me low again. Running out of time. I'm going to make it happen. This is the time. Like Godfist hits. I'm going to keep... Yeah, I had to go for a reset there. I had no choice. Yeah, I'm going for time overs now. Keep blocking, keep blocking, keep blocking. Yes! Yes! Because they both have no health, I was able to hang on with that tenuous life lead. Let's see if I can finish the job. I just jumped in that time. Just kind of wait my turn. Frames! Pretty generous, not gonna lie. Catch me again! Man! The timing on these block strings! I wouldn't think you would have all of that advantage. Let's walk into them now. Just do it. Walk into it. I'm not afraid of you. There we go. Wait my turn. Do something fancy. Got him with the overhead. I missed it. Nope, I got that. Pretty good. We good? Dot, dot, dot. Da-da-da-da-da. Da-da. So we're going to have to work on... You know, Psycho Crush probably helped me a lot in that matchup when I think about it. If I just raw Psycho Crusher and tagged a Hachi for a juggle, I'd actually have a lot of benefits of doing that against Dalsim. Because that gets me in without having to worry about just walking and getting hit by all these low attacks that reach under me. Psycho Crusher can just surf over that because it's like hovering over a bit. Because that was actually off the ground, unlike the Scissor Kicks. Okie dokie, I'm going to wrap things up here. Hope you enjoyed the Discord tournament and that bonus match. Let me show you some fan mail I got not too long ago. I was playing somebody else, he said that I play very lame. And so much so, he was telling me like, yeah, we're talking about that, where is it? Here we go, you ran every time. It was boring. Yeah, basically some guys think I'm too lame. Yeah, always a pleasure, Jay. Thanks for dropping by. If you guys like what you see, please continue to support Street Fighter Cross Tekken at the... where is it? At the Street Fighter Cross Tekken Discord, which you can see up here. And while you're at it, please check out the Street Fighter Cross Tekken Complete dossier. So I have a physical copy of this guidebook that I wrote along with the rest of Discord, and I'm going to be giving it directly to that Ian guy I told you about, the esports dude at Capcom, to show him the work we have put into this game to develop it into what it is today. The fact that we have been playing this game for almost 8 years... when so many people wrote it off after 2 being generous, that shows how good this game is, that shows how good the community is, and that shows why it's worthy of getting a full-on official rejuvenation. I will push that hard when I speak to Ian at Capcom Cup Finals while I'm doing all of his Street Fighter V AE work along with the rest of CrossCounter TV. Please join the Discord. I'd love to play you guys sometime. Also, within the next few weeks, we will be having another Marvelous Meetings tournament. This is the official PC ranking event for the Faded 2 World Championship Series. If you play Infinite and you are a PC warrior, look no further than Marvelous Meetings. The next one's going to be in about a couple weeks. It'll be Sunday at 3 p.m., and I will give you guys the exact date within the next couple of days. I look at my schedule and see what else I'm going to be doing, because we're also going to be resuming the next Dead or Alive 6 Duo Fantasy Tournament. We finally got this off the ground earlier last month, and it was a blast. I'm not going to lie, I had a great time with this stuff, and I look forward to doing more of these things with the rest of the Dare Live community. They all loved what we had to offer here at XWIRES, and look forward to doing more of these things. Also, finally, there is an NBA 2K Playgrounds 2 update on the way. I am pretty gosh darn sure I'm going to be seeing it before next Saturday. They've been hanging on to this huge update since, like, the end of September. And the only reason I can think of they haven't released to the consoles yet is because 2K is telling them wait until the season starts. And it starts on, like, Wednesday, I think. So by Thursday or Friday, we should have this new update. Hopefully it has all the stuff I wanted, like spectator mode, things like that. Either way, we will have a crossplay crossovers event for you guys. This game's pretty dope. Hopefully 2K doesn't ruin it like they ruined their mainline series. If not, we'll find out when I do my first one for the new update. Also, I have a W All-Stars coach. You guys know that? This game's actually pretty dope. Powered by Parsec, you can now play this game. I have all the things you need to play this game on Parsec in the official Discord for the game, which you can find right here. Please join it. The game's actually pretty dope. I actually wrote a lot of the SRK guide for it back when the game was fresh, so you can see a lot of the movements and stuff and how you play each character you want to play. Plus, we have the DLC characters, too, like Mark Henry, as you can see up here. Additionally, Power Rangers Battle for the Grid has another update coming out, I think, on Tuesday. I've been playing this game a lot with my friends. I actually have a new batch of footage I got to upload from last night's party. I've been playing Ranger Slayer a lot more lately, and she's actually pretty hype. Because before, she was kind of a forfeit button for me. So, play this game, too. It's cheap. It's compatible like almost everything, and there's crossplay for this, and really gosh darn nice netcode. I like this game a lot. I didn't think it'd be any good, but it's actually gosh darn fantastic. In the interim, this is Psycho Blue, conductor of the Hype Train, Mr. Hype Gems, hashtag XWIRES. I'll see you guys next time, and again, look forward to all the footage I'm going to be uploading of all these games. Marvel, Cross Tekken, Dare Alive 6, Playgrounds, Power Rangers, Neo Geo Battle Coliseum sometimes. And obviously, as I've said throughout this stream, I will be at Capcom Cup Finals, and I will have the Cross Tekken dossier with me. I'm going to do what I can to make sure Cross Tekken gets the push it needs to be back at the forefront. And if I don't have an answer for that, at least know what we'll have to do to make an answer for that. Either they tell me no, if I can just learn why they say no and they lay out the logistics of it, then we'll kind of know where we stand, what we have to do from here to help guide them to our way of thinking, you know? Either way, look forward to it. Look forward to all the great games. And I will see you guys next time. Have a wonderful Sunday afternoon, everyone. Later.